Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another long division of polynomials problem. And in this one we've been given the rational function, in other words a fraction here, x cubed minus 5x squared plus 3x minus 5 minus 15 divided by x squared plus 3. And in order to set up our long division problem, we need to put our denominator out in front and our numerator inside bracket here. So x cubed minus 5x squared plus 3x minus 15. And this is just like the long division that we learned in elementary school, except with polynomials. So just like the long division we learned in elementary school, we need to always be looking at these first two terms here. And we have to decide what we need to multiply by x squared in order to get the result x cubed. Well, that one's pretty simple. We know that if we multiply x squared by x, then we'll get x cubed. So we write x here up on top. And then whatever we write on top, we're going to take and multiply through the polynomial out in front here. So x times x squared gives us x cubed, and then we're going to write these in order. And then x times positive 3 gives us a 3x. Now, the important thing to realize here is that we've got a specific order of terms here. We've got a third degree term, second degree term, first degree term, x here, and then a constant. So we need to make sure that we line up the degree of our terms when we distribute what's on top here by the polynomial in front. So in other words, when we multiply x by 3 here, we get 3x. Well, that's not an x squared term, so we're actually going to put it over here under the matching degree term. This is 3x to the first. We've got 3x to the first. It's not an x squared. It's an x to the first term. So we're going to line it up under here. Okay? So then what we want to do is just go ahead and draw parentheses around your result and then put a minus sign out in front because we're going to subtract. So x to the third minus x to the third gives us 0. There's no term here for x squared, so we get basically negative 5x squared minus 0, which results in still a negative 5x squared. So we go ahead and leave that. Then we have 3x minus a positive 3x is just a 3x minus 3x, which is going to be 0. And then when we're done performing that subtraction, we always want to remember to bring down the next term that we haven't used, which is this negative 15 here. So we want to bring down the negative 15. And even though you've got all these zeros in here, just go ahead and leave things lined up the way they are because it'll keep it simpler. So now we need to figure out what to multiply by x squared in order to get the result negative 5x squared. Well, that's just going to be a negative 5. So we go ahead and say minus 5. Now we have to multiply the negative 5 throughout x squared plus 3. So negative 5 times x squared gives us a negative 5x squared. So we want to line that up with the x squared term, which is right here. So negative 5x squared. Then negative 5 times positive 3 is a negative 15. So we want to line that up with the constant, which is going to be over here. So negative 15. And now that we're done multiplying through, again, we can put parentheses in front here, put out our minus sign, and subtract. So obviously we don't need to worry about the zero. Negative 5x squared minus a negative 5x squared is basically going to turn this into a negative 5x squared plus 5x squared, which is zero. We don't have to worry about this zero. We can skip that. And then negative 15 minus a negative 15 is going to be negative 15 plus 15, which is going to be zero. So this function happened to divide perfectly, right? We didn't have any kind of remainder. We just had zeros at the bottom. So the final answer here is x minus 5. The denominator divided perfectly into the numerator of our rational function. So that's it. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.